Hi, thanks for tuning in, and welcome to another TV Box Stop review. Today my review is on a Windows Mini PC by Alfawise, which can also perform as an Android TV box. This device is the Alfawise X5, Dual Operating System Intel Mini PC. In this review, I'll examine its hardware and features, and how it performs as a standard Windows PC, and how it also functions as an Android TV box. We also have benchmark scores in my final opinion. This review is extended beyond the usual duration, due to having to feature both operating systems, so stay tuned, we have more in a moment. So I'm back, and let's first start with the unboxing. The product comes in this black box with the X5 logo at the top with an Intel pattern. To the side we have some specifications. It shows that the model is the X5. The CPU is the Intel Atom X5Z8350 processor, running up to 1.9 GHz on 2 MB of cache. Its graphics is powered by the Intel HD Graphics 400, with 12 execution units, running up to 500 MHz. Its memory is 2 GB of LPDDR3 RAM, 1600 MHz frequency. Its onboard storage is 32 GB of eMMC 5.0. It has 802.11 single band 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 4.0. It has Ethernet LAN speed of up to 1000 MB per second. Its power is supplied by a 12 volts 1.5 amps DC power adapter of 100 to 240 volts, operating at 50 or 60 Hz. So it's time to unpack the contents of the box. And when I return, I'll continue. In the box, you have the unit itself. You get one HDMI cable, your DC power adapter. You have a system activation instructions and a user operation guide. Let's have a look at its ports. To the back, you have one HDMI port, one USB 3.0 port, one RJ45 Ethernet LAN port, one audio-video port, a reset pinhole button, a DC power input, and a red power button. To the side, you have two USB 2.0 ports, an SD card slot, and two ventilation holes. And there's nothing on the other side. To the front, you have an LED power light. To the top you have the Alfawise branding. And to the bottom, you have very small ventilation holes. So I'll connect this device to my TV, and when I return we have the rest of the review. So I'm back, and as I power on the box, you're presented with the option to select which operating system you would like to start. So I'll start with the Windows operating system. The Windows operating system is a fully functional Windows 10 version, and you can install any program you would normally install on a standard desktop PC or laptop. So we are looking at the home screen, and I don't need to go into details about how to use the Windows operating system, because just about everyone in the world knows how to use it. So let's take a look at some system and hardware information. The internal storage was partitioned into two sections, so let's see how much is allocated to the Windows installation. Under system information, for some reason the program cannot read the manufacturer and model of the device, the only information that shows is the internal storage. It shows that the Windows partition has 14.92 GB of storage, and 1.7 GB remaining. Now this is a bit of a problem. The Windows installation used up most of the partition's space, leaving very little room to install apps and games. And to make things more difficult, there isn't any SATA expansion slots or M.2 slots to add additional storage. Under CPU information, it shows that the CPU is a 64-bit quad-core Cherry Trail Intel Atom X5 Z8350 CPU, running at 1.4 GHz. If I open Windows system information, it shows that the X5 comes with 2 GB of RAM, and it only has 691 MB remaining. Under display, it shows that the GPU is the Intel HD Graphics, which is actually the Intel HD Graphics 400, and for some reason it's not showing that information in this section. Under network, if you scroll down you will see that the device only comes with single band 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi, and it has Bluetooth capability. Under Windows, it shows that the operating system is Windows 10, and it also shows that it's the 64-bit version. And that's all for system and hardware information. Because of my limited internal storage, I could only install a couple benchmark programs, so let's take a look at the results. I have the results of the Antutu benchmark. The results show that the X5 got an Antutu score of 71,333. This is a pretty high score for the X5. I also have the results of the Geekbench 4 CPU benchmark. And it shows that the X5 scored 807 single-core and 2,070 multi-core. These are all the results I can provide on this limited storage, so I'll switch over to the Android operating system. So I'm at the Android operating system, and let's take a look at some system and hardware information. Under system information, here it shows that the manufacturer is Intel, and the model is the PC box. Below it shows that the box has 2 GB of DDR3 RAM, and below it shows the remaining memory and internal storage from the 10 GB assigned to this partition, after the operating system and the apps installed on the box. Under CPU information, it shows that the CPU is a 64-bit quad-core Cherry Trail Intel Atom X5 Z8350 CPU, and in this partition, it's running at 1.9 GHz. It also shows that it only has support for 32-bit ABIs, which limits it to 32-bit applications. Under display information, it shows your screen resolution, and it shows that the display is powered by the Intel HD Graphics, which is actually the Intel HD Graphics 400 GPU, with a refresh rate of 60 Hz. Under network information, it shows that the box has support for only 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi, and it also shows its signal strength, link speed and frequency. Under Android information, it shows the version installed is Android 5.1 Lollipop, and below it also shows that the box is not rooted. Under thermal information, the box runs around 55 to 60 degrees Celsius on normal cooling, and around 40 to 50 degrees on passive cooling. Under codecs information, it shows that you have codecs like H.264, HEVC, and VP9 decoding, all needed for 4K video playback. And that's it for system and hardware information, and I'll now check to see if the partition is rooted. It shows that the partition is not rooted, running on Android 5.1 Lollipop operating system. I guess they had to use this version due to storage limitations. We now move on to the benchmarks. First, we have the memory read and write speeds. The X5 has a RAM copy speed of 3774 megabytes per second. The internal memory has a read speed of 98 megabytes per second and a write speed of 39. The SD card slot has a read speed of 17 megabytes per second and a write speed of 11. These scores are a bit on the low side, given the hardware used in this box. I now have the results from the Wi-Fi speed test. The scores were okay on my 30 megabytes internet package. However, the box is capable of achieving much better scores on a faster network over 100 megabytes, like a fiber network with much higher speeds. We now have the results from the Antutu benchmark. When all tests were complete, the X5 got an Antutu score of 53,937. This score is okay, but I was expecting a higher score given the hardware used in this box. Next, we have the results from the Geekbench 4 CPU benchmark. After the series of time tasks were complete, the X5 scored a Geekbench score of 847 single core and 1909 multi core. And for my final benchmark, I have the Ice Storm Extreme 3D graphics benchmark. After all the 3D graphics tests were complete, the X5 got a score of 8511. This is average for the hardware used in this box. That's it for the benchmarks. The 4K video samples did not play so well under this operating system. Some of the videos refused to play due to file format issue. So you will have a limited 4K video playback experience on this mini PC. You may have a better experience under the Windows partition, but the lack of storage may pose a problem. It appears that the Alfawise X5 is better at playing games than it is at playing 4K videos, so let's take in some gaming action. These games contain some shooting, fighting and blood, so parental discretion is advised. As you can see, the games ran better on the Android partition than most regular TV boxes due to the Intel hardware. I couldn't play any games on the Windows partition, because there just wasn't enough available storage. So in summary, the Alfawise X5 mini PC would have been better off if they had used 64GB of internal storage, and used Android 7.1 instead of Android 5.1. After reviewing this mini PC, I felt like this device would have been a heck of an Android TV box, if they use only one operating system like Android 7.1, and that would have been something to see. However, the concept of the box is good, but they fell short on storage and memory allocation. There are also no expansion ports like a SATA port or an M.2 port to remedy this issue. They could have also included a wireless mouse or a mini touchpad keyboard in this package, so I am left feeling wanting on this device. So I have come to the end of my review of the Alfawise X5 Dual Operating System, Mini PC and Android TV Box. For more information, see the link provided in the description area. Thanks for watching. Remember to like this video if you found it informative, share it with your friends, and subscribe to this channel for more TV Box top reviews.